Abel Sanchez makes excuses for his fighter Triple G not to fight Demetrius Boo Boo Andrade. Stay tuned. Boxing Eagle here. If you like this video, make sure you hit the like button and also subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon on the top of your screen to get notified when the latest new content drops. One. What up, fight world? It's your boy Ego, and I'm back with some more boxing. Make sure you smash the like button. Also, subscribe to the channel for the latest and greatest in boxing. If you want to become part of the gang, notification gang, please hit the bell icon. Shout out to the Super Chat channel donations, the Venmo donations, and the Patreon family. We working. Well. Abel Sanchez, trainer of Gennady Golovkin, he did an interview with Behind the Gloves, and let's get right into it. He says that Golovkin understands the business of boxing. He knows he didn't lose to Canelo. He may know that he didn't get the decision, but he knows he didn't lose. I think Canelo is catching the wrath for that. These are direct quotes from Abel Sanchez. He says Golovkin's definitely not going to retire. He then went on and says that Golovkin walks around at 170, so if he wants to continue fighting at 160, it's his decision. I would like to see him go after another run at 160 and make some history, some more, and then maybe move to 168. If it's something we all agree on, then that's what Golovkin will do. You know, he's talking about potentially moving up. But this is the part that you guys see in the title. He says the way Demetrius Andrade looked is going to be difficult to get anyone interested in that fight. He's a very talented guy, but he's done enough, just enough to win. His last fight left a lot of questions unanswered. He's a good fighter, but what does anyone have to gain by fighting? So he's basically saying that Demetrius Andrade, it doesn't make sense. He also goes on and says that Charlo, unless you're a champion and someone orders a mandatory, then yes. But what does he bring to the table? Charlo continues to be idle. Who's his next fight? Willie Monroe? Wow. Well, I seen this coming. I predicted it. New media. I mean, it is what it is. You guys let me know. So, one, Demetrius Andrade is a champion now. He was going to fight a better fighter in Billy Joe Saunders, but through no fault of his own, Billy Joe Saunders failed a drug test. Fact. Right? So the fight got pulled. The plug got pulled on that particular fight. He did what he had to do. He was nursing, a shoulder injury versus Walter Katandakwa. And, you know, Walter Katandakwa was tough. And he was a wild card. Andre was training for a southpaw, more slick boxer. And then he got a guy who has less technique from Namibia, who looked like he had heavy hands and was just awkward because he wasn't really polished, you know? And he was tough. And he just kept getting up. He got knocked down like 4 times. He was getting up like the Terminator. Then there's an excuse to not fight Charlo, saying, what has he done? And he's been idle. Who's he fighting? Willie Monroe. But when Triple G fought Willie Monroe, that was all sunshines and rainbows. You know, this is just a terrible look for Abel Sanchez to make these statements, right? So it seems like you're just pursuing a money fight. Like, you know, going to try to haunt Canelo until he gives you the opportunity. You know, because you're ruling out every, you know, top black fighter that's in the division that are all good fights. The only people, and the funny thing is in this interview, he says that Rob Brant is an option. So what's the difference between Rob Brant and Jermall Charlo? You know, Rob Brant beat Ryota Murata. Murata already had a loss to Hassan Indom. Jermall Charlo's undefeated. And he's bigger and he's bigger known, bigger name, better talker. So it's going to be a better build up and show. Right, he has an awesome jab. He was a former champion in a previous division. You know, they both know Errol Spence. You know, Rob Brant used to train in Texas, but they both have a version of the belt. The WBC ordered the fight, you know. So if you really want to fight Canelo, why not go through Charlo? You know, you're already saying that the Andre fight don't make sense. I mean, this is just crazy. Then Daniel Jacobs, what about him? He just became a champion. Triple G is like literally cornered and surrounded with tough and good fights. A rematch with Jacobs. Boo Boo Andrade, a champion. Jacobs, a champion. That's a tough fight. You already gave him a tough fight. Or an interim WBC order Jermall Charlo. And he's talking about Rob Brant. Tom Loeffler's talking about Ryota Murata. So that gives you everything you need to know about the direction of Triple G's character and like what they're trying to do and what they're trying to build. It looks like they're trying to stay safe for a potential Canelo fight, you know, not take too much risk. And at 36, I don't think Triple G's really earned that luxury, you know, to not have to climb back up the ladder. And then they're trying to use this against Canelo, like, oh, Canelo still has to prove something. This man made, he has guaranteed money now with DAZN. He doesn't have to fight Triple G. He doesn't have to worry about pay-per-views, you know? And I really don't even care about seeing a trilogy, especially immediately, you know? There's a lot of good fights and, you know, it's just, it's a bad look because this seems to be the case with Team Golovkin is they're down to fight certain people, but not others. Like, you wanted to fight Floyd Mayweather at 154, maybe even Manny Pacquiao. Abel Sanchez said at a point, but you didn't want to fight Canelo at 155. You know, you didn't want to fight Badu Jack at 168 when Floyd Mayweather kept suggesting it. You didn't want to fight Andre Ward at 168, but you were down to fight someone that Andre Ward defeated with one hand, and that was Carl Froch. You were down to fight Julio Cesar Chavez Jr., who we know would have lost to Ward most likely if they fought. You know, I don't think it's most likely, but obviously it didn't happen. But from a skill point, you know, we know what happened, right? Zurdo Ramirez called you out, you know? It's just, this is, to me, this is not a good look. Andre said he'll fill in. Derevchenko said he'll fill in when Canelo failed his drug test. You let Jacobs fight Derevchenko, who proved to be a tough fighter, who, in my view, would have been tougher than Vonis Modarosyan coming off a loss to Edislandi Lada, 2 years layoff off the couch, and then also coming from the 154-pound division, moving up to 160, you know? And this is who Triple G is targeting. So it sounds like he's became, or maybe he always was, what he criticized in others, a business person, person looking for the strategy and trying to get the bag. You got two Canelo paydays, and, you know, I guess that's not good enough. You're trying to get Canelo for a third fight, you know, that no one's even really tripping off. The second fight didn't even do the same, the as good as the first fight in terms of live gate or the pay-per-view viewership and buys, you know? And now on top of that, Canelo got $365 million. You know, it's just these things, it's not a good look because there's really no justification for it. Your team is saying that they want Triple G to fight Ryota Murata, who just lost, or Rob Brandt, you know? But then making reasons why Demetrius Andrade doesn't make sense. Charlo doesn't make sense. Not really speaking about Daniel Jacobs. There's too many guys in your division. This is what they said and they clamored for. You know, Billy Joe Saunders was an option before he failed his drug test. And then he kept saying, hey, I got me pinned. And then, you know, he looked the other way. Like, ultimately, it's not a good look. Let me know what you guys think. I don't know. It's just, it's... Nah, I'm not even shocked. It's just what I told you. You know, that's what I've been saying. And we'll see how it all plays out, who Triple G signs with and who he decides to fight. But I hope his team gets together and analyzes his next move and realizes that. How are you going to dip out and really dodge the prime guys that you could possibly fight, you know, and then target Murata or Brandt out of all of them? You know, how can you say what has Charlo done, but then you want to fight Ryota Murata with two losses? You know, you want to fight Rob Brandt with a loss and lesser known. You know, it's not a good look. And like I said, they've cornered themselves because they said Golovkin understands the business and basically made it sound like it's politics and bad judging why he lost to Canelo. So there's really no reason to even take a tune-up, because in this same interview, Abel Sanchez is admitting that Golovkin knows he didn't lose. So if he knows he didn't lose to Canelo, then there's really no reason to regress, you know? Like if LeBron and the Lakers play a team and the referee had a blown call and that's the only reason they lost the game, like they said a basket didn't count and it really left his hand before the buzzer went off, and then they reviewed it under, you know, instant replay, but it was too late and they just kept it like that, then LeBron wouldn't hold his head high because he knows he really would have won that game. You know what I'm saying? So there's really no reason to take a step back like that in caliber of competition. You know, a guy who's trying to get the experience. And, you know, I have nothing against Rob Brandt, but he's trying to get experience in the big fights, and then you're trying to target him, you know, because he has a version of the belt when the WBC ordered you to fight another guy with the version of the belt, which is a bigger and better fight. You know, just this is like carefully tiptoeing to try to get to the Canelo finish line, and it's very apparent, you know. Let me know what you guys think. Drop your thoughts in the comment section. Make sure you smash the like button as always. Hate, comment, and subscribe. Till next video is Ego signing off. So if you enjoyed this video and want more content like this on the channel, you can show your appreciation by going to the PayPal donate button or the YouTube support button, and you can donate any amount that you feel is equivalent to the value of this video. Much more to come. Thank you guys for your support. Boxing Ego, the future of boxing.